My name is Julia. I am a junior, and I went to Dingle this past spring semester.
My name is Jackie O'Rourke. I am a junior journalism major, and I went to Dingle last semester in the spring.
My experience in Dingle is really, like, I could go on and on about it, but it was 100% the best thing I ever did. I got to make so many memories and meet so many new people, and it definitely just pushes you out of your comfort zone, but you also, like, are welcomed in by all these people of Dingle who you never would have met, so it just feels like home, like, almost right away.
My experience abroad was absolutely amazing. I made so many memories. I got to experience so many unique things that I wouldn't anywhere else besides Dingle. I made so many great friends within the other SHU and Dingle students and also with the local Dingle people. I didn't do this on purpose, but the jacket I'm wearing, my friend Kirda, who is a local Dingle girl, gave this to me to remember her.
The communications program was unlike anything I probably would have experienced at Sacred Heart here in Fairfield. I got to intern, which I probably wouldn't have done until this year now if I hadn't gone to Dingle my sophomore year. And it was also in different fields. Like, I got to explore, like, entertainment, promotions, and, like, a couple different, like, interviews also. So it was really cool because you just got to dip your toe in everything. And the professor that we had really cared about us. Like, he would take us on field trips and make sure we saw everything that he wanted us to see.
The communications program in Dingle is very hands-on, and we went out and filmed in a lot of really cool locations, and we got to interview people. So I felt like we got to learn more about Dingle that way, because we got to interview people and see places that not everyone else got to. We helped our professor named Mickey, who is a filmmaker. He was filming a documentary, and we would help him go and interview people. It was about people who weren't from Dingle but had moved to Dingle to start a business or start, like, they all had a reason they moved, so we would help him interview them and set up the different equipment.
I think it was absolutely useful as far as communication studies goes and my education, because I got to learn a lot. I got to, like I said, I, like, got to dip my toe in everything and just learn all these different fields within the field of communications. And I had a lot of fun with it. And I also, as far as just, like, life in general, it was really useful, because it was like I had no idea how to cook before I went to Ireland, and then, like, I learned, and just, like, living in the houses and getting to meet everyone, learning how to live, like, by yourself in a foreign country really puts you out there, and it helps you grow as a person. I mean, it's still school, and I think people tend to forget about, like, the study part of study abroad, but it was a really big component, but it was also not overbearing, where we got to experience the Irish culture and life outside of the classroom, like, while we were learning, like, for our classes. Like, we would go and interview people in their homes and talk to these Irish people, or even people from other places, and we would get to go on drives around the peninsula on different field trips for class. So it was really interesting, and that, like, just because we were in school and taking classes didn't mean that we weren't getting to see the landscape and experience the culture while we were doing it.
It's very relaxed compared to here. It's not as intense and intimidating, and, like, the syllabus isn't as strict. Like, things got moved around a little, and it wasn't as tight-knit. It was kind of more free-flowing, but it still worked. Like, it's still college.
What is your favorite memory from Dingle?
Oh, that's hard.
It's so hard to choose just one, because it's, like, so many little things throughout the whole semester.
Sleighhead Drive is really cool, and then also there's a walk along next to the hotel that's right by the water. So all the different locations in Dingle and just experiencing those, I guess. I can't even pick one favorite memory.
Being there and getting to go on all these different hikes, even if just the hike was, like, flat on, like, just a 2-hour thing, like, on lunchtime, and go out and, like, see the nature, and, like, everything is so green, and you could just walk right up to, like, goats and pet them and sheep. but then also like all the little shops in town, like going to get like groceries and cooking with our friends like in our house, and experiencing like all the different foods of Ireland, which I miss all the time. I miss the food, but yeah, I think everything. It's hard to pick just one little thing because they all added up to so much.
I think our relationship is really unique, like as friends, because we didn't know each other before Dingle. So like when you're in a setting like that with someone you've never met before, especially when you're in a room, like sharing a room with somebody you've never met, and I'm sure like everyone knows from freshman year, it's like you get to know your roommate really quick or you don't get along. And we clicked almost immediately, and then like we were forced to know each other like basically because we had all the same classes together.
Yeah, I've only known Julia since January, but with all the different memories and stuff we've gone through, I feel like she's been one of my good friends for years. I think my favorite memory with Julia would be on Easter, because both of us were without our families and it was kind of sad, but we made it into something positive, and we got dressed up and went to Mass, and we went out to brunch, and then we sat at home and watched a movie and had dinner. So even though we weren't with our families, we still made like a family dinner in Dingle.
I think my favorite memory with Jackie is probably like all the traveling we got to do, because it was definitely a big opportunity that we got in Dingle. And we got to like go around Galway and London with the program, and then we also like we went away on spring break together, because at the time like we were roommates and we were like one of the only people that we knew and were good friends when we booked spring break. So like we just got a group together, and then we went to France, we went to Italy and Monaco and Spain, and we got to do a lot of really cool stuff. So I think that's really unique.
We got a different experience, like seeing them both as a friend and like getting to like, go out and socialize in Ireland and go out with the friends that we met there, and also like all the weird quirky things that happen when you're working with someone in communications, and like especially when we were doing like interviews and things like that, where like there was one guy who was teaching us how to use a drone and his car got stuck in the sand on the beach in Dingle, and like we had to work to get it out. And it's just like those random little things that happen behind the scenes that like we got to bond over. It's my favorite stuff.
I miss Dingle every single day and I want to go back. And I love, even if I don't ever get to go back, I know that it's going to be a part of me and I'm always going to have those memories there. But I definitely just miss like everything about it.
I miss everyone so much. I want to go back so bad. You will never have an opportunity like this to do it again. And I know some people say, oh, you only have 4 years of college, but you have your whole life to travel. But I don't really believe in that. I think you should study abroad and travel while you're in college, because you get to do it while you're in college and not when you're out of it and have to worry about loans and living on your own. Like, if you do it while you're studying abroad, you get to still go to school and make all these experiences. So I think you should do it.
Even if it's scary, even if it's something that like you think you might not be able to handle, then just go for it. Take that leap, because it's 100% worth it. Even if you get there and you think maybe it's not the right fit for you the first day or two, like you got to get out there and you have to push yourself out of your comfort zone and like try all those new things. Because if you're sitting in your house in Ireland, then you're going to be just as bored as you are sitting in your dorm at Sacred Heart. But like, if you go there and you get out there and you do everything that they offer you, because it's endless what there is to do, then it's going to change your life. Not to sound cliche, but like it really, just take the leap for it.